Okay. Welcome back to our live budget coverage. We have Niranjan Hiranandani now joining us and Nimish Shah as well. If everybody can just settle around the studio, please, thank you. You can please carry on. Yeah, thank you. So, yeah, Niranjan Hiranandani is with us. Niranjan, are you there? Can't see you on the screen.
Yeah, I am
how
very
are
much
you, Niranjan?
There,
yeah.
Waiting for you.
Yeah, how are you, Niranjan? Broad expectations, Niranjan. What do you think?
All good.
Give me the broad picture. What are your expectations, Niranjan?
I think the focus is going to be on employment. I think the industries where the employment potential is the highest, I think infrastructure, housing, textiles, and things like that, where I think the employment is going to be taken up, is going to be the serious areas where I think the finance minister will or have to concentrate. Because if you don't do that, the disappointment is long term.
Yeah.
And at the beginning of this 5-year tenure, I think employment is going to be the real focus area. Of course, I also think that there will be a lot of gives which the Prime Minister has promised into various segments of society. So you are going to get some new things up the sleeve for the 5-year tenure. So I'm having huge, big expectations of changes to take place.
Yeah, sure you can. Ratan has a question for you. Yes, Ratan, go ahead. Ratan Sharda has a question for you. Go on.
Yeah. Revival, but looking at the deep depression the housing is in currently with so much of unsold stock, commercial as a residential, how do you think government can actually help you revive? Because there is a serious issue here, so how do you think it will revive itself?
You have to understand that there is a huge liquidity crisis which has taken place in the marketplace. Today, banks have got collected 1,75,000 crores of rupees in deposits, which they have put in Reserve Bank of India and government bonds. All this liquidity has to come out into the market.
Yeah.
The moment this liquidity position improves, demand is very much there in the marketplace.
Okay.
So I don't see the correction in GST, which was required to be done, has been brought down from 12% to 5%. So that also is going to make a major change in the whole economy. And the affordable housing segment, we have got interest subvention, where you GST is only 1% and interest subvention is 3%.
Can I pick up the elephant in the room? Can I pick up the elephant of the room? And I would like to start with Niranjan on it. I want to have a discussion on it. The elephant in the room is inheritance tax or estate tax, because you know, why aren't we talking about it? Are you too scared to talk about it?
No.
Everyone's scared to talk about it. You know, like Niranjan, there is this looming fear, right? That's going to make a comeback. See, he's smiling. He knows about it. Everybody's known. Everybody's whispering. Everybody's calling each other. Hey, listen, is there going to be a estate tax? Yeah, oh, there, I'm right, right? Everyone's on the screen. Look at everyone smiling. Everywhere you go today, Mumbai, Delhi, anywhere, WhatsApp University, estate tax, estate tax, estate tax. What is your view on it? Like, Niranjan, come on.
Arnab, you have to understand, if there is virus in the air, you have to accept the virus in the air and just pray that you don't get the virus. That's all. I mean, you can't wish away a virus. This virus is there amongst all the people, and now we have to wait and see whether
the virus
is caught on to us or not.
No,
have to remember two things.
No, what is the virus? What is the virus? There are two views on this virus. Which side are you on? What are you calling? Yeah.
I think it would be stupid on the part of the government to bring in an inheritance tax. Estate duty which already existed. They found that the collection cost is more than the estate duty which actually came in. If they want to bring it away, again,
no, but
it
what
is
about
only a perception
the, no,
in the country
sorry.
For the purposes.
No, but you know, Niranjan, this is only Richie Rich. The richie rich people will be using gifting of heirlooms as a method for tax evasion. There is skepticism among our people today. There's a government. It thinks about the poor people of this country. They voted for the government. This government has a Robin Hood image. It wants to punish the richie rich. And it says the richie rich use this as a method for tax evasion. Taxation on gifting is negligible and non-existent. You bring the tax back, it'll be more accountability. Richie rich, ultra rich will not be able to go through the cycle of tax-free heirlooms. That's the, now don't tell me, that's not my view, but that's a view among a lot of people who they're right. Oh, there, am I right? Uday, am I right? Come on, Amar. Come on, Amar. Am I right or wrong? Why are you people backing me up? Uday, am I right?
Yes, yes.
Am I right? Tell Niranjan. He's waving his hands about. He's richy rich. He's ultra rich. He's concerned about it. But you know, this government is made of Robin Hoods.
Inheritance tax is not necessarily.
Yes, you counter Niranjan.
Inheritance tax is not necessarily a revenue objective only. It is also a social objective. Much
exactly,
larger.
Yeah.
It is there in many parts of the world. US has it. Uh-huh. Of course, 1%, the top 1% of the people
look
pay
that. He's upset. Look at Niranjan.
Is there a limit of? So there will be a larger limit. Whether it will come in this budget or not is a question. In my view, I don't think it will come in this budget.
But Nimish Shah is also there with us, I'm told.
Possibly.
Nimish Shah is also there with us. Let's drag him into this discussion.
Possibly.
That's the only channel that talks about inconvenient issues. Nimish Shah, good morning.
Just one.
No. I want you to all counter. All you people here, you see Mumbai, rich people, South Bombay, cannot decide what happens in the rest of the country. Nimish, are you nervous about inheritance tax? If you are, say it. No harm in saying it, Nimish.
No, not at all.
No, you're not.
No.
Niranjan is.
No, absolutely not. Because first of all, I do not know how it will even help immediately. Because it's not a tax which you start imposing, it will start coming immediately. Plus, let me tell you, there are some brilliant chartered accountants with extra fertile minds who created various trust structures. You know, there'll be ways and means to, I won't say evade it, but
come on, Nimish. This is the problem the government faces.
But,
smart chartered accountants, extra smart chartered accountants are the problem in this country.
No,
he doesn't agree. Emma, jump right in, Emma. Emma in the middle takes over my place.
Tell Nimish. I disagree on this particular issue.
You tell Nimish. Chartered accountant is something wrong, sir. You cannot say that the chartered accountants have to be blamed for anything. No, I think I am seated next to the past president of the institute. I think we cannot say that
you chartered accountants have created the problem.
No, sorry, sir.
You chartered accountants.
This cannot be a statement.
There are consultants.
Oh, God, I didn't realize I had the past president of ICA in the studio. Sorry.
Let's not get into semantics.
I'm joking. The problem with chartered accountants is that they have no sense of
humor. You see the success of GST. Success of GST implementation. Because of chartered accountants, it was very difficult to implement the GST.
We're moving away from
consultants, advisors.
One minute.
Advisors. You call them family friends. You call them well-wishers. You call them an uncle in the family. Okay.
Yes.
Let's not get into a semantical battle here. Okay?
No, we're joking.
Forget it. You know, we are talking about a well-wisher in the family who will find out ways and means. Okay.
Yes.
If that helps.
Now tell me, Nimish.
Forget it.
I've got the adrenaline back on the show.
Yeah,
now that I've said that. What I've got some pictures. Look at these pictures. Magnificent pictures coming in out there. And that is Nirmala Sitaraman's cavalcade. That's it. I mean, pretty simple. Nowadays, it's no longer, you know, those horse chariots. Those are pictures that are coming in from Delhi. Okay. Now let's look at the big picture. I think what this government needs to do is put in, Niranjan, a huge stimulus for investment. Massive foreign investment must come in. Domestic investment must be unleashed. And for God's sake, Niranjan, this liquidity crisis following the collapse of NBFCs, whatever it is, get on with it. You know, you get to cut your losses and move on. But for us, wherever you go, we can't keep whining about a liquidity crisis. What do you think, Niranjan?
I think if the banks are not lending, we need to at least convert 50 good NBFCs into banks, because the banks have now become too old and they are not really agile enough to meet the marketplace requirement. I think you need to expand the base of banks completely.
I'm with you.
And there are lots of good NBFCs. Of course, there are bad NBFCs
I'm
also.
With you.
But I think
I'm with
we
you.
Need to add at least 20, 30
Man,
new
I'm
banks
with you, Niranjan.
Today. Because unless you don't do that, monies are going into the banks.
Niranjan, I'm with you.
But they are not going into credit to the people.
I'm with you. This is a ridiculous position.
You can't have the money sitting in the banks and not going to the business, not going to the people of India. Why do you have the banks?
I think we all agree. Do you agree with me on this? We have a bizarre situation in this country today. We have capital locked up. We need capital. We have capital. We've damn locked the whole capital up. We have today a situation. We have 14 lakh crores of stressed assets on the one side, right? And we need to resolve this issue. We need to unlock bank capital.
I can't be paying a price anymore because of NBFC folded up. Just a moment.
Are you with me in this, Brinda?
We need growth capital, not just capital for regulation.
I mean growth capital.
We need growth capital.
Of course we need it.
Yes, of course. And the thing is that we have the money. But then avenues to lend.
But what can the budget do in that? Can the budget do anything in that?
I don't think budget is addressing this issue of NBFCs to be converted into banks or
But can they not give a broad direction to this?
What will happen in this is, you see, we already had the interim budget tax changes have been done. Direct tax changes have been already done there. Just allow me to finish. GST Council will keep on adjusting the tax rates for the indirect taxes.
I think you already have a plan.
So I think, and there is a big shortfall in numbers. I think the budget will have to find out where the shortfall is, how that can be bridged.
Let's get Niranjan. Can I just get Niranjan and come back to one point to the other? Yes, Niranjan.
There is a very big problem in the whole economy. We have no bank today which does long-term lending for the purposes of infrastructure or for housing, for making long-term projects. There was in the good old days an ICICI, an IDBI, and various banks were there. Today, all the banks are doing short-term collection of money and giving long. I think we need to have structured new banks to come in, which handle infrastructure funding.
But banks are nervous.
Today we have
none. No, but banks are nervous.
We need new banks.
I'm saying this. Banks are nervous. There is scrutiny.
They're going to say, what the hell are we going to do?
One second, we have pictures of Nirmala Sitharaman now. And those are pictures of Nirmala Sitharaman. Niranjan, just coming back to you. Those are pictures of Nirmala Sitharaman walking in, and this time not with the suitcase, but with this beautiful bag in which it's made out of cloth and there's golden lace around it, with the Ashok's thumb out there, and to her right, the young and dapper Minister of State for Finance, rising star of the BJP, is Anurag Thakur. Nirmala Sitharam, Anurag Thakur are now going in. The Modi government has an opportunity. How far are they going to go? Everyone's saying one thing, but I'd say one thing clearly. I am with those who say unlock the capital, unlock the capital. The difference is, if you know the broad thinking in this government, Nimish, you know about this. MR can tell you more about this. You see, Amit Shah's role now in government, I know he's a home minister, but Amit Shah is also a superarching minister. And he's the BJP president. He gives a political direction now. Anyone who knows Amit Shah knows that his focus is on domestic, reviving domestic economy, reviving domestic production, reviving domestic consumption. His view has always been revive domestic consumption. How do you revive domestic consumption if nobody is lending money? Nobody is lending money and the banks. I want to know, State Bank of India, what's it going to do? Does it help Mr. Naresh Goyal or not help Mr. Naresh Goyal? If it does not help Mr. Naresh Goyal, at that point of time, it is damned. If it helps Mr. Naresh Goyal, it is doomed. So what is the problem? I'm saying there's a nervous... Vishal, the problem with you is you're not getting the picture. Nobody wants to come under scrutiny.
Yes.
You have thrown the baby out with the bathwater. Am I right, Niranjan?
Yes.
Did you lend money to MR Venkatesh? Why did you lend money to MR Venkatesh when you knew the NBFC crisis was on? Am I right?
Absolutely.
Niranjan.
Like you got new airlines, like you get new telecom companies, like you get new TV channels like Republic, unless you don't get fresh blood into the financial institutions and the systems to work out quickly all the logjam of capital capital logjam of credit, which is not moving into the marketplace, is a major problem. You can't have an economy without liquidity. It is like having a motor car without oil. You can't have a motor car which has no oil. You may have a big motor car at 7% growth, but if you don't have liquidity, that car will not move. So it can't move. You have to provide the liquidity, and you have to provide it today.
No, the banks are not lending because... The banks are not lending because yeah. On the one hand, you have a DHFL crisis. Right. On the other hand, you have an ILFS crisis. You have a problem with looking at the auditors. You have a problem of compliance within these big companies. You have an SFI. You know, you have a scam everywhere. The banks are not lending. And at the end of the day, the Ministry of Finance says the declining growth rate in the previous financial year is because of the declining rate of domestic consumption. There is no doubt about it. We need to open up domestic consumption. People need to buy.
Arnab, it's not only
look
growth,
at the automobile
it's a question
sector.
Of liquidity which stops the entire engine from functioning. The whole engine is going to be log-jammed if there is no liquidity. All this growth they are talking about, 7%, will not be achieved if you don't get the liquidity into position.
Of course,
you know,
we need the liquidity.
To boost domestic consumption, do you know for every rupee that a farmer's purchasing power increases, it impacts India's GDP by 3 rupees. This is the power of the purchasing power of rural India. Now we are focusing too much on the, you know, increased consumption, but unless consumption in rural India doesn't increase, and consumption in rural India will increase when you give more, you focus more on your agricultural sector. 66% of your workforce, 66% of your workforce is directly related to agriculture.
No, if you want to open up employment, I'm sorry, I disagree with you. You have to have a huge push towards
housing.
Infrastructure. I'm looking forward to that. Not just industry. We are looking forward to something. There has to be capital infusion. There has to be some bold step. Money must go into the domestic market, and it needs to go now. There is an electoral promise.
And
the BJP said, Savio, in its manifesto, make a capital investment of 100,000 lakh crores in the infrastructure. Anchor inflation at 4%. I want to see the first step towards that this time. As a citizen of India, I want to see massive spending, massive infrastructure, massive employment. Savio, can we see that
public investment? What about private investment? Where is private investment?
Of course, we can see that happen. But for that to happen, the government has to ensure money is available in the hands of the people to increase consumption. And I agree with Mr. Niranjan Hiranandani that it's important for the government to open up the banks, to loosen the purse strings.
Open it
up. But it has to be cautious, because if you look at the past, the banks have actually gone absolutely nil because of non-performing assets. So the government and the banks need to work with the right kind of companies, with the right kind of entrepreneurs, especially the young entrepreneurs that are coming out of India, to help them build this economy. And that is where the future is.
Okay, I have with me Rimjim Chatterjee, former chairperson of the Northern Region of CII. I don't know if Mr. Dua is still with us. Mr. Dua, sorry, I know you're in the studio out there. I haven't come to you. I'm extremely sorry, but if you're there, I'd like to throw my next question at you. You've been secretary, sir, in the government of India. My question is to Mr. Dua. Mr. Dua, please, is he there? Okay, Ms. Rimjim Chatterjee, what can we see this time in terms of broad infrastructure which we are talking about, massive capital infusion? You are especially interested in employment and employability. Is the capital investment not the basis for that now?
Said before, is a great multiplier, and therefore a lot of employment opportunities can come about. However, there is a huge issue before us in terms of funding for infrastructure. In the last couple of years, we've seen that infrastructure creation has actually been through public expenditure, but there is very little headroom available right now. So we have to ensure that there are other opportunities that are available for innovative funding.
Thank you. Okay.
And I'd like to mention three things. One is that we have been talking about disinvestment for a very long time. We haven't seen enough action there. Yeah. So I hope that this budget will throw some light on that, because that will then bring in ability for state and central governments to invest in infrastructure.
Yeah.
The
yeah.
second point I'd like to make is that a lot of infrastructure requirement is actually at the urban level. Urban infrastructure must be possible for us to fund through municipal bonds, and we have not done enough about that as well.
I want to go back on infrastructure, and I want to go back to the debate on infrastructure. Can we do that this time? Like, you know, every year the amount of money for infrastructure development has gone up. 1.9 trillion, first budget, 5.97 trillion, 2018-19 budget. Do we see a breakthrough number there this time? Come on.
Arnab, it is not only the amount that you're going to spend on roads and airports, which is a traditional infrastructure. Today, coming from Chennai, I would like to invest in water. Water is a huge crisis. We would like to see irrigation, we would like to see micromanagement of river systems, we would like to regenerate, repair and restore water bodies in various districts, taluk and block levels. These are the things that a budget probably can probably tell you as a broad direction, give you the outlay. But outcomes are a different proposition. And
I'm also with me. I'm keeping it moving fast. Yeah. I am constantly talking about options. Abhay Aima, HDFC Securities. Abhay, hi, good morning. You know, what kind of capital infusion can this government make possibly in the finance sector? Because the whole issue today is NPAs and NBFCs. NPAs and NBFCs. We need to get some direction in this budget on how these two issues could possibly be dealt with. Abhay, you have any thoughts?
Yeah, see, you need to definitely recapitalize the bank and PSU banks for growth. Also, if you see the economic survey, the best I've seen so far, there is a connection between, very well established, between, you know, growth, consumption, exports, all of these are interlinked and you cannot treat them independently or separately. On NBFCs, I think you cannot take a general view because some of them have not got their business model right and need to suffer. But you need to change the sentiment for that. So that is what is required. The problem is, where does the capital come from? I think there will be some, from what I read in the economic survey yesterday, I think there is a possibility of some surprises and some innovative ways to raise capital.
What do you think? What do you see from the economic survey? What do you see from the economic survey?
I think it was one of the best economic surveys I have seen. For the first time, someone touched on behavioral science, someone touched on, you know, law, how important it is. And the way it was explained and the examples given, it wasn't just theory, there was a lot of practicality in it. So if the finance minister was to take a cue from there, you might be seeing some surprises in this budget, even things like labor reforms, because it was very well explained in that, you know, what is the necessity, why it is done. And logically, like I said, I haven't seen a better economic survey before.
Oh, absolutely. I'll take a short break right now. The elephant of the room is inheritance tax. I don't know why, because every budget it is spoken about. But I think it also tells us about India as a country. You know, is a country we keep saving. And we keep saving to give to the next generation. And maybe that also tells you about the amount of wealth that has been built in. Also possibly tells you about what smart chartered accountants are looking at this budget for. You see, the problem is chartered accountants. Chartered accountants are in business on budget day. Congratulations to you. Don't be defensive. I think the question today is,
you agreed that the chartered accountant is the backbone for the country development.
What would we do without chartered accountants?
Yes, that is it. I was asking. I was asking the Nimbiz when he was talking about.
I never said
he will be the first person to.
Okay, here are some of my questions. My questions on capital infusion, which I'm going to deal with in the finance sector. Will, with the NPAs down, will the budget infuse capital in banks broadly? Will it give boost to all your ICRA predictions on your NPAs? Will there be a huge infusion in the public sector banks? Is there the money for the infusion in the public sector banks? Will your scheduled commercial banks face relief from turbulent closing balances of the NBAs? Will there be some? Will
the Danu scheme, and he was recapitalizing, and there were some attempts to recapitalize, but the problem was 15 lakh crores versus 50,000 crores
when
as a solution.
We are dealing.
That's the problem today.
No, the problem is 10.4 trillion rupees of NPAs in 2017-18.
That's a problem. 10 to 15 lakh crores of NPA versus 50,000 crores.
Can you write it off? We can't write it off.
We have to use the NCLT as a process. We have to use the Money Laundering Act as a process. We have to use simple OTS as a process.
There is no one solution.
But
without
for
judicial reform, where are the courts? Where are the courts?
See,
that
the NCLT today is not delivering.
Where is, what about the speed of delivery of justice? You know, when will results be shown? When will this money or at least part of it come back into the system?
That's what I'm saying. There are no recoveries.
The budget by itself cannot do much. We need a parallel process happening together. And this parallel process is what India needs today. But if you compare India with other countries on the same growth path of their economy, you will see that India has perhaps reached a stage where very high investment is needed. If we have to go on that trajectory, how will this investment come? This investment will come through fiscal expansion. And I feel, you know, what the government, the signals the government has given over the past couple of days. You see, in defense, there are views that there have been steps taken for the procurement of 115 aircrafts. In the Navy has given, inquiries to 7 shipyards. So there are signals. The government is on the verge of a major fiscal expansion. Once that happens, what will happen?
But I think we need to be a little careful on this fiscal expansion.
No, it will boost the economy. Your infrastructure.
We can't just say.
We'll take a short break.
This is a signal.
We'll take a short break. Keep in mind the broad picture is this is a budget being presented in the absence of an opposition. This is a budget being presented in the absence of an opposition. No opposition this time. Right, I'm not hyping it. Truly, this is a budget that the government is presenting to itself. Because there is no opposition in the country today. What does that mean for what will be presented? 42 minutes to go, short break, and I'll be back.